Welcome to the show that focuses on the positive, things to live for. Here's Rick.
Hi, thanks for clicking over to our show. When your birthday is near, or when the December holidays like Christmas or Hanukkah come around, many of us look forward to receiving gifts from friends and family. Aside from the anticipation of not knowing what we'll get, there's also the nice feeling that somebody cared enough to give us a present. When we tear off that wrapping paper, we're so giddy inside that we feel like we're back to our childhood. Whether we love the gift or just like it, the surprise of the big reveal is just so much fun. Then, of course, we have the pleasure of enjoying what was given. There are presents that we like right away, but some that we learn to love. The other part of gift giving that's just awesome is when you're the one giving the present. First of all, you're just happy to be able to give a gift to someone. We've all had rough times when we couldn't afford to do it, so we're happy when we are capable of giving. The other great thing about presents is when you've chosen the perfect gift for someone. When we really put some thought into it and the recipient just loves what we gave, that feeling right there is nothing short of fantastic. Giving gifts is just one way we show our love to people. And just like when we give our love, when we give presents without expecting anything in return, our satisfaction is on another level. Thanks for joining this edition of Things to Live For. Remember, we update our website almost every day, and we drop new episodes 2 to 3 times a week. So check thingstoliveFor.com regularly. That's thingstoliveFor.com with the number 2. I'm Rick. Have a blessed day.
This edition of the Things to Live For podcast is made possible by Daryl Woods. Check out his music and videos at darylwoods.com. That's D-A-R-Y-L, Woods with a Z.com.
Are you in crisis? Or do you know anyone who might be? You are not alone. And help is available. If you're in the U.S., visit suicidepreventionlifeline.org. If you're outside the U.S., visit iasp.info. Help is just a click away.